his head, but he just did.
Just so happened.
And that's five on Waterloo, so it's going to be DiLoretto shooting. Johnson, two fouls for the 6'5 forward. DiLoretto.
Three shots up. It's a little short there.
Good. DiLoretto shooting. Very good. 82% from the line. It's a rare miss for him.
You see a second one, and he gets that one. That's what we usually see from him.
Yep.
And we have Stevenson coming down the court here up against Higgins. Passing it off there to Clean, and Chuck D took it away as he goes down the floor.
Oh,
the foul is going to be called. Chuck D is going to stand the line for two shots and see the replay there.
Hard foul there on Chuck D, but you're going to foul him hard, I guess, if you're Waterloo. Chuck D goes to the line. Only 53% from the line on the season. Not many attempts, but that looks pretty darn good.
Let's boost up his numbers there.
Mm-hmm.
And he's on the board as well. And second shot is up, and gets it. Stevenson coming down the court here for Waterloo. Moving around the right side. Coming back, handing it off there to Melbourne as he's going to try to push inside the key there. We're going to have Stevenson for the shot, and Bernard with that rebound. Great height right there as he's going to come down the floor here for the Stangs. Inside the key, passing it off to Chuck D. Up top to Schultes. He's going to try to go through the key himself.
Oh, how about that finish? Great finish in the lane from Schultes. He's got 11 in the first quarter.
Mustangs lead again, 17-15. We have Stevenson moving around here, trying to pass it down to that corner to Amen. He takes a shot, but Bernard taking it back here for the Stangs. Waterloo on defense. DiLoretto with the ball, passing it off to Charlie. Inside to DiLoretto again, but can't get up there.
That's a good defensive play.
Wanted a foul called on that one, but wasn't. And Stevenson passing it off there to Amen. Clean handing it there to Stevenson for the three.
How about that? With Chuck D in his face. Makes the three.
Pull Warriors back up to the lead just by 1 point. Chuck D passing it there to Higgins. Let's see what we can do about this. Schultes going inside. Tried getting it down there to Charlie.
May have hit Chuck D in the face.
Long pass is going to be taken and aiming on the Warriors. Has the ball in his hands now. Off to Stevenson. Stevenson moving around up for a shot. And rebounded there. Going to be hit off of a Waterloo player. Off of Max Clean.
Coach Campbell wanting an over-the-back foul called on that play, and I don't blame him. Challenging the referee. Ask him why you call foul on that.
We have Barbeau and Nick Berardi in the game again, and also Quinn Henderson here. See if we can get some more points back on the scoreboard. Berardi for the shot, rebounded there by Phil Giano. Amen coming down the floor with the ball here for the Warriors, passing it off there to Angelini. Back in Wright's hands as he's back on the court. 8 seconds left on the first quarter. Wright's going to go through the key. Oh, whistle is blown on that play right there.
So it's going to be a shooting foul for Mustang foul number 21, Nick Berardi. It's going to be baseline.
It's going to be foul on Nick Berardi. So Western's fourth foul this quarter, but not big of a deal. Only 2 seconds left.
Shoot.
The shot is taken by Angelini. Doesn't quite make it. That is the end of the first quarter. We have Waterloo at 18, and our Western Mustangs just behind by 1 point at 17.
Very good job by the Mustangs fighting back in that quarter, and this week's Good Life Fitness Female Athlete of the Week is track and field star Caroline Earhart. Caroline competes in triple jump and long jump with the Mustangs, and over the weekend at the 29th annual Don Ray Team Challenge, she improved her own school record for triple jump. This placed her second in the event and number two in the Canadian rankings. Caroline also won the long jump event, and her efforts helped lead the Mustangs to a women's team title at the meet. Caroline is currently part of Athletics Canada's 2016 Olympic Development Program, and her biggest goal right now is to get to the games. Caroline Earhart, your Good Life Fitness Female Athlete of the Week. We'll be right back with the second quarter here on Mustangs TV.
New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and four of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating.
A great car is not built from just parts, it's built from ideas. Like best-in-class fuel efficiency with every engine, not just the hybrid. The all-new 2012 Toyota Camry, made from 30 years of our most brilliant thinking. A great car is not built...
And we're back here on Mustangs TV. In the second quarter, we have men's basketball Mustangs facing Waterloo Warriors.
That was a good job by the Mustangs fighting back. They trailed at 1 point, 11-2, had the lead. And they only trail by one here, thanks very much to Peter Schultes, who has been the team so far. 11 points for Peter.
We have Wright with the ball, passing it off there to Bridge for the shot, and he gets it. Wayne Bridge for the three.
The three-pointers for Waterloo.
This second quarter.
My goodness.
Quinn Henderson up top, off to Berardi. Moving the ball around like we usually see here. Quinn Henderson, cross court to Berardi.
That's dangerous and really poor play there.
Wright got his hands on that one and it ended up Warriors ball.
It's been the three-pointer that's done it. They're 5 for 8 from beyond the arc. Trying to make it 6 for 9. Nope.
Tolchev with that shot, and Barbeau making a long pass there to Quinn Henderson, and he's going to get it. Great fast play there by the Stangs.
Beautiful.
We have Wright with the ball. Western on defense. As he passes it off there to Bridge. He's going to go up for the shot. Charlie with that rebound, handing off there to Barbeau. He comes racing down the floor.
Hey.
And there's Ryan Barbeau.
Took him 12 minutes to get on the board, which is rare for him, but that was a very nice play. Like I said, he likes to drive to the basket, and we got an offensive foul on Waterloo.
We have Peter Schultes, who looks like he's going to come back into the game here, take Nick Berardi off for a rest.
Justin Johnson already has three fouls for Waterloo, so.
We have Max Kleon back in the game as well. Barbeau coming down the floor, off to Charlie. Druin to Barbeau, to Higgins, back to Barbeau. Looked like he was gonna take a shot, but Higgins is gonna take it instead, and Ryan Higgins for the three.
Finally hits a three.
Stangs up the lead again, 24-21. Wright with the ball here for the Warriors. Passing off there to Bridge, and there's going to be a travel called against Wayne Bridge, and it's going to be Western's ball here to the side.
A little bit of a tap dance there from Mr. Bridge, and that is not legal in the game of basketball. But see what Ryan Barbeau can do here in the second quarter, waiting for him really to take over. He does it every game. You know, to see him with only 2 points to this point. He had 18 points to this point last game.
Peter Schultes with it in his hands. Now off to Quinn Henderson. Foul is going to be called there on Mike Wright.
I thought it might have been a good play there as Quinn Henderson narrowly avoids our camera person down there. Mr. Henderson will shoot too.
Our Her shot is up, and he just misses that one, but he has one more to come.
70% shooter on the season from the line. But he makes none of them.
Either. Ends up back in Quinn's hands. He saves it from Waterloo. Western's going to get another chance here. Ryan Higgins back inside to Schultes to the corner.
Oh,
for
that's
the
crisp
shot from Nathan DiLoretto.
Didn't have much time to release there, but it was a beautiful shot.
We have Melbourne with the ball, passing it there to Clean. Down to the corner to Wright, and Wright up against Barbeau.
Oh, that was a beautiful pass.
Always to the other side to Bridge for the shot, and we have Barbeau with that rebound for the Stangs, and Warriors will be back on defense as Ryan comes down the floor. Off to Quinn Henderson, to DiLoretto, to Barbeau, quick passes. Henderson with that shot, right. Another three for our Western Mustangs. Quinn Henderson finished that one off. Timeout is called by Waterloo. The score is Mustangs 30, Warriors 21.
University of Western Ontario has 241 academic All-Canadian athletes, and tonight our second hero of the classroom is Brian Hong. Brian plays for the 28-time consecutive OUA champion Mustang squash team. He's in his third year at Western, first year of Ivy, with an interest in investment management and consulting. Named the OUA Player of the Year in 2009, Ryan also loves to play golf and travel. A huge Toronto Maple Leafs fan, he's keeping his fingers crossed that they make the playoffs this year. And his biggest fear is graduation because he doesn't want to leave Western. Ryan Hung, a hero of the classroom.
Investment management and consulting, that is a mouthful right there.
Mm-hmm.
Good for
so
him.
So is 28 consecutive time OUA Mustang champion squash team, but that is impressive.
Yes, it is.
To win it once is great. To win it 28, that's almost mind-boggling.
All right, and that's the end of the timeout here for Waterloo.
Western managed to build up a 9-point advantage here. A blistering start to the second quarter thanks to threes made by DiLoretto and Quinn Henderson. 7 minutes still to go here in the second quarter. DiLoretto has already got 7 points. Schultes 11. Very good tandem.
All right, and we're back in the game here. Bridge passing it off there to Angelini for the shot. The whistle is blown before that ball could get back up to the net.
It's going to be on Schultes. Two fouls on him. Chuck D is going to come in for Mr. Schultes.
We don't want Peter fouling out this game. Not in the.
We need him on the floor. He's been the all-star so far.
Heat that he's been going off.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Waterloo's ball here, passing it off to Wright as he moves around the court, losing it there to Barbeau as he goes down the floor himself.
No, that's a travel.
Calling a travel on Ryan Barbeau.
Goes down the floor himself.
I thought it was a good one, too. And up. Tough call.
Win some, you lose some, and we have Wright coming down the floor here. Looked like he was going to get off to Melbourne again, but not a good idea. And he goes up for the shot.
Wow. Mike Wright in the lane. Oh, Barbeau had Henderson streaking to the basket. I don't think he saw him.
DiLoretto passing it off to Henderson. Movement here from the Stangs. It's going to be foul against Andrew Melbourne from the Waterloo Warriors. That's the team's third foul in the second quarter.
Still 6:13 to go. We might be seeing some free throws in the not-so-distant future.
Barbeau telling Charlie where he wants him. Passing it off there to DiLoretto for the shot. And then we have Melbourne with that rebound. Wright with it in his hands now. Western on their defense as Wright goes down, takes his shot a little long there, but Charlie Drouin got that rebound and gives it off to Barbeau as he's going down strong just outside of the key here. Makes a long pass to Henderson for the three. And can't get that rebound.
And that's Di Loretto with the foul there. That's going to be his first highly contested rebound. There had three guys up there trying to get the ball, and Di Loretto a little too physical, so they called him on the foul.
We have Jermaine Bernard coming in here for Nathan Di Loretto.
Both Di Loretto and Henderson, they were feeling it earlier, but we got back-to-back misses from them. Tough ones there.
Waterloo with the ball right with the three. A little short there.
Oh, but they...
But
Higgins
he's getting
has
it back
on
now.
The there.
Passing it off to Melbourne as he holds onto it and goes inside the key. A long shot there, and he gets it. Just over 5 minutes left in this quarter. We have Barbeau coming down the floor, handing off to Henderson, to Bernard. Bernard's going to take that three. Doesn't make it. He needs somebody inside for those rebounds because Melbourne keeps getting them. So he's going around and taking his shot as well, but Bernard got that one underneath his net. Barbeau with it now. Off to Bernard. Barbeau passing inside to Charlie. Charlie moving around, trying to get up inside the key, up himself.
Oh, just slid off the back rim and out of play. That's a tough one there. Mustangs fans, share your thoughts with us on Twitter. Tell us where you're watching from and what you think of the team's performance tonight. Follow at Mustangs TV and use hashtag Mustangs TV when tweeting about Mustangs athletics.
All right. We have Stevenson with the ball here for Waterloo, losing his dribble but giving it off there to Melbourne. Back to Stevenson. We'll see who that's off of, who they call it. It's going to be Waterloo ball down in Western's end. It looks like it came off a Western player there in the corner. Passes in, 3 seconds left on that shot clock, but lands in Henderson's hands, and Barbeau's going to take it down now. Passing it out to Bernard. Is he going to go through the key?
Oh, look at that.
Wide open space for Jermaine Bernard, and he gets it in.
The fearless finger roll from Bernard. Wonderful job.
Stevenson's coming down the floor here for the Warriors, handing it off there to Eamon. Travel is going to be called, and Western's ball here to the side.
Got a timeout. Waterloo, the score is 32 for Western and 25 for Waterloo Warriors. We'll be right back with more second quarter action here on Mustangs TV.
TV.
This week's Good Life Fitness Male Athlete of the Week and OUA Athlete of the Week is hockey goaltender Josh Eunice. Josh is in his second year at Western and is currently the fourth-ranked goalie in Canada. He shut out the number 8-ranked Lakehead Thunderbolts twice this past weekend, blocking all 56 shots sent his direction. Those were his second and third shutouts of the season, respectively. Holland, Ontario native, currently has the best save percentage in Ontario. He has been to two training camps with the Chicago Blackhawks and the former Atlanta Thrashers and was drafted in the third round by the Blackhawks in 2007. He played on Team USA in 2006 and 2007 in the under-18 divisions and also played on Team USA in the World Junior 2009 Championship. Josh Eunice, Good Life Fitness Male Athlete of the Week.
And Barbeau up top here with the ball. Up for the shot. It's a little short there, but it's going to be rebounded by Phil Giano.
Forced it a bit there.
And have Stevenson coming down the floor here. Western on defense. Stevenson up against Bernard, giving it off there to Eamon. He's working hard against Barbeau, passing it there to Melbourne. 7 seconds left on that shot clock, and the shot is taken, and it's too long, and Quinn Henderson got that rebound. Coming down the floor here, off to Bernard. He's looking for Barbeau. Charlie for the shot.
That's unlucky.
We have Stevenson with the ball now. Western moving back on their D. He's going to go around. Looked like he was going to take a shot there, but he gives it off to Pajici.
That's a nice play there. Prejic with a very nice effort. Getting the basket to go and one. And that'll be the first foul for Quinn Henderson. Surgeon Prejic at the line. Definitely has the distinction of having the hardest name to pronounce, as you see it there on your screen. So forgive us if we sound a little messy with his pronunciation. But Prejic at the line.
I don't even want to try his first name there.
Where's the fouls?
Well, he made his shot, and we have Charlie giving it in here to Barbeau. And we have Anthony Spiritas in the game for the Stangs.
Seen some second quarter action.
Barbeau passing it there to Charlie. Charlie trying to get down underneath the basket to Bernard, but couldn't get it in his hands.
Trying to fit it into a tight window. There was no room there, though. It's not Tom Brady. He's Chuck D.
We have Wright coming down the left side of the court here, up against Bernard. Moving around, going inside the key himself and passing it back out there to Melbourne. Almost losing it from Spiritas, and Melbourne's going to take that shot. Rebounded there.
Nice effort there by Berardi.
Bernard coming down the floor off to Barbeau for the shot. And too short. Waterloo's going to end up with the ball here. Melbourne with it on the left side of the court. Off there to Bridge as he goes inside. Tried giving it down there to Phil Giano, but Wright makes a long pass to Melbourne. Finishes it off there 4-3 in the last 4 seconds left that he had
Silky
on that shot clock.
From Andrew Melbourne.
Barbeau with it now off to Chuck D. Waterloo is on defense, holding it tight. Charlie's trying to get inside that key, and he goes up for the shot, and the foul is called
against
Waterloo.
Good effort there from Chuck D again, getting dirty in the paint. Go to the line, and he'll shoot too.
Western's only up by 1 point right now, 32-31.
Big lead that they'd have got to start this quarter has quickly disappeared. The well's gone dry on offense. We'll see if Chuck D can try to fix that. Some free throws.
Nick Berardi's taking a break. We have Ryan Higgins back in the game for the Stangs.
Nice shot there from Chuck D. One more to go. Mr. Druin. First year out of Oakville. Makes both shots.
Second one is good. 34-31 for the Stangs. We have Wright coming down the floor up against Bernard. Handing it off there to Bridge. He loses his dribble but gives it back to Wright. He's going to take that long three. Doesn't quite make it. Rebounded there by Charlie.
Oh.
Barbeau coming down the floor up against Waterloo D inside to Spiritas.
Check that out. Oh, how did I not go down?
Looks like that was going in for sure, and it came back out right down the left side of the court here. Try getting to that rim, but gives it off here to Angelini. We're going to have Melbourne up top making the call. 9 seconds left on that shot clock. It's going to be a foul called.
The foul on, I believe it's Bernard. Could be Spiritas. It is Spiritas. First foul, and he's going to be taken off the floor by Mr. Quinn Henderson. 51 seconds to go here. Western hanging on to a 3-point lead. Struggling to keep hold of this lead, but they've managed to throughout this whole second quarter.
Wright passing it off there, Angelini. Angelini's trying going for that shot, but throws it off to Wright, and he goes inside the key.
And a travel.
Travel is called on Mike Wright. Western ball underneath their net. We have 40 seconds left on this clock in the second quarter. Bernard with it in his hands as he comes down the floor up against the Warriors. Off to Charlie. Charlie hands it there to Bernard. Across the court to Quinn. Ryan Barbeau trying to pass it back to the top there to Quinn, but
went off Angelini's face.
It is Western ball underneath Warriors net though, and he throws it in there to Quinn.
Got only 5 seconds.
Barbeau's gonna take that shot.
Not happening today for Ryan Barbeau.
And Bridge coming down the floor here. Taking it back around. He's gonna use up.
Whoa, he's over and back. I can't believe he just did that.
Just barely, he didn't even realize where he was.
I don't think I've ever seen that at this level of basketball. Just lost track of where he was on the court. Instead of taking a transition layup, I understood the turning around. Try to use the clock to get your last possession as the time expires, but he just gave the Mustangs a free pass with 9 seconds to go.
Barbeau with 7 seconds left, off to Henderson, back to Ryan. Ryan's going to have to finish it off here. And
no, he traveled.
Basket does not count. He traveled.
He's having a tough evening so far tonight. Ryan Barbeau, if you can believe it, only has 2 points on the evening. Very uncommon to see that from the fifth-year captain. Look at that. Let's see this.
All right, and that is the end of the first half. We have our Western Mustangs up by 3-34 against the Waterloo Warriors at 31.
That's been the three-point shooting of Waterloo that's kept them in this game. And for Western, they need Ryan Barbeau to get it going. Schulte has cooled off a bit there in the second quarter, still only has 11. But after getting off to such a hot start, they're up 31-20 at one point. Or sorry, 30-21. But they went ice cold over the last half of that second quarter. Something else. Well, we'll be back in a bit with more Western Mustangs basketball here on Mustangs TV.
You don't have to have owned a Corolla to know a Corolla.
But maybe now your time has come.
The new 2011 Corolla. New style, new standard safety features, and as fuel efficient as ever. It's the car you can count on.
If I get a good job, I'm gonna steal 2 bases.
Yeah. will.
What is the good life? It's about being totally alive in every fiber, every thought, every moment. It isn't complicated, it's as simple as letting your body move. The good life's not about magazine covers, it's about pictures on your mantle. It's not about what you see in a mirror, but about what you see inside. Yes, the good life does include ice cream, pizza, and a cold beer on a hot day. The good life is putting down the remote and taking control. It's about playing with your kids in the park and feeling like a kid yourself. It's about balance in a world that often forgets the meaning of that word. Good life is hearing your name and seeing a familiar smile. Good life is good, and it's within your reach. Grab it now.
New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and four of the minerals lost in sweat.
Children.
We'll find out in a minute, but right now we've got an interview. Go down.
I'm here with Western Mustangs head coach Brad Campbell. Now, coach, you guys have a 3-point lead right now. What did you tell the team to focus on in the second half to maintain that lead?
Well, we basically talked about at halftime, you know, we didn't play very well, and we're still up 3 points. We're a little too lethargic. You know, our cuts aren't good enough. We got guys turning down shots. We just need to play with a little bit more focus and, you know, just with a little bit more confidence. I mean, we're able to do it. We just have to show ourselves that we can do it.
And Ryan Barbeau is one of your top players. Do you think you're going to play him in the second half, or are you going to rest him?
Ryan's definitely got to play. We need to ride him. He's going to need to have a good second half for us to win this game.
All right, well, thank you so much, and good luck in the second half. Back to you guys.
Thank you. And looking back at the first half stats, it's been the three-pointer. It was the story in the first, but it cooled down, Waterloo did, in the second quarter, shooting 43% on the game, 6 for 14. Mustang shooting 4 for 15, good for only 27%. Ryan Barbeau shooting 1 for 5 on the day. That is very rare for him. Peter Schulte is 4 for 5. He's still the leader with 11 points. Meanwhile, a lot of players chipping in for Waterloo. You've got Melbourne with 7, Wright with 7, Brachich with 6. And the score, 34-31. We will take a break, and we will be back.
Back here are Western Mustangs versus the Waterloo Warriors. Western up just by 3 points, 34-31. Yep. And this is the second half of the game.
Yep. If you're wondering when the next home game is for the Western Mustangs, it is not until Saturday, the 4th of February. So not this Saturday, but next Saturday. That'll be at 1 and 3 p.m., the doubleheader, and we'll, of course, have that here on Mustangs TV.
And we have an answer to our trivia question. Around this time last year, the Mustangs and the Warriors played to a final score of 93-72, and who won that game? The answer is the Waterloo Warriors. Mm. Hopefully we can turn that around tonight. Yep. Yeah, Peter Schulte's inside the key here for the Stangs.
There
up
it is.
For another 2 points for Peter.
See, he was missing those shots last game. And that was a big difference in his game today, as he has 13 starting the second half off on a good note.
We have right up top here, going inside, coming back out. He's going to pass it off there to Angelini. 5 seconds left on that shot clock. Wright takes the shot and doesn't
quite make it, but it's rebounded there by Bridge.
Ryan Barbeau with the ball now, coming down the left side of the court here for the Stangs. Off to Charlie to Higgins inside the Schultes, as he's going to go up strong there.
And he's going to draw the foul. Very well done again from Schultes, and we got another whistle there. Some extra after the whistle shenanigans going on here. But Schultes getting intense. It's good to see. You want a guy to be intense. He'll shoot two here. He's been shooting very well from the line today.
First shot is up, and it is good.
Peter Schultes.
Has he really missed anything tonight?
Oh, he's 4 for 4 now from the line. Of course you said that. You jinxed him.
All right, we have Wright coming down the floor here for the Warriors, passing it off, moving that ball around. Melbourne with it now, giving it to Bridge as he's trying to get inside. Can't quite get there, and passing it back out, and we have Melbourne
drawing
out that foul.
Henderson picks up his second foul of the day. Melbourne heads to the line, shooting 61% from the free throw line. 0 for 0 on the day. Not many free throws have been attempted. It's only the second free throw attempt of the game for the entire Waterloo squad. But he makes the first.
He's got a second one coming up right here. Andrew Melbourne. Oh, doesn't get that last one there, but Charlie got that rebound. It's going to be Western coming in on offense. Peter Schultes inside.
Oh, look at that beautiful back door.
Higgins. We have Wright with it now. Off to Angelini. Giving it there to Johnson. He almost loses it. But Bridge has it up top now. 10 seconds on that shot clock. We'll see what he does with it. Gives it off to Wright for a shot, and he gets it. Barbeau's coming down the floor now. Warriors on defense.
Very nice shooting stroke from Mike Wright. He's been taking all kinds of shots, and he looks very good tonight. Oh, what a save.
Peter Schultes trying to pass it there to Barbeau. Looks like Ryan Higgins saved the day there. Schultes back to Barbeau for the shot.
Just can't get it going tonight.
Just too short.
He has been shorting arming a lot of these shots. I don't know what it is, if he's tired or something, but of course he hits that after the whistle. Shot clock problems. They didn't reset it. Ryan Barbeau did hit the rim. I'll put 21 back on the clock. Barbeau can't blame him if he's a little frustrated here.
Western's only up by 3 points. They haven't really had that big of a lead lately.
No, they haven't. And Mustangs fans, after the game, make sure to check out westernmustangs.ca for up-to-date Mustang scores, schedule, stories, and highlights. westernmustangs.ca is your source for all Western Mustangs information.
Whoa. Ryan Barbeau with the ball now, took it away as he comes down the court.
Look at that.
Off
pass
to Higgins, and Higgins finishes it up there for the Stangs.
What a bounce pass from Mr. Barbeau. If he's not putting it in the basket, he can still dish it.
We have Melbourne with it now, passing it down into the corners. He goes under the net. Johnson passing it there to Wright, and he finishes it off with a three.
That guy's open. It doesn't seem like he's going to miss. Shooting very well today.
We have Henderson with the ball off to Higgins. Moving it around there. Barbeau has it now, passing it out. Higgins for the three.
Attaboy.
And he gets it.
Ryan Higgins. Luckily, he's starting to heat up. He's got 10 points on the day.
Angelini trying to get inside that key, passing it out there to Melbourne for the shot.
Melbourne with a nice stroke. He's up to 10 as well. Oh, we've got 6.5 to go. Mustangs still holding on to that 3-point lead.
Ryan Barbeau off to Higgins. Henderson with it up top, looking inside for Schultes. Can't quite give it to him, but Higgins did, and he's turning around for the net. Henderson can't get that rebound either, and Bridge got it instead and hands it off there to Wright. Back to Bridge here, Western on defense, handing it off to Melbourne. And a whistle is blown on that call. It's going to be against Quinn Henderson.
A three on Henderson. He'll take a seat, as is Charlie D. We got Bernard and DiLoretto coming back in. It looks like Spiritus. Oh, he's just greeting his teammates on the bench. Waterloo Warriors a chance to tie the game here with a three. Still 6 minutes left, though, in the third quarter of play.
Right up top here with the ball. Barbeau just got screened there. Up for a shot from the Warriors. DiLoretto with that rebound. Barbeau's going to take it down the court. It's going to be foul called against Max Kalian from the Warriors.
The boy from Dubai gets his second foul of the day. 6'6", first year. Just getting some action early on in his career.
Peter Schultes with the ball off to DiLoretto. Back to Schultes, he's looking around what to do. Wanted to pass it down under the net to Barbeau there. He's going to be off of black, so Western's ball underneath Waterloo's net.
Only 12 seconds left. Western really doesn't have an incredibly good inbound play. They just get the ball inbounds and let the offense try to get a good look, which is okay, and of course that is not good.
Some miscommunication there.
That is not acceptable. And a close, tight game, one that you can easily win.
Mustangs those kind just of plays. Up by yep. only 3 points here.
Can't have those kind of plays.
One shot can make the difference from the Warriors. And Stevenson in a little bit of trouble there, but Wright has it back up top now for the Warriors up against Western D. 7 seconds
That's
left
bad.
On the shot clock, but Barbeau stole it off instead.
Oh, he missed a layup.
Get that layup.
Oh, they're going to call that goaltending. No. Let's take a look here. Nope. They're not calling it goaltending. They're calling it a foul. Oh. If there was a foul, it was after the shot. You saw it on the replay there. I can't believe Barbeau missed a layup, though. That's incredible. That's the fourth foul on Perchich.
We have Ryan Barbeau at the line here.
Yeah, there you go.
That's his first one.
If you need to get your shot going, get your confidence up, why not head to the free throw line? Knock down a couple free throws, and that's exactly what Barbeau does.
We have Stevenson coming down the floor hard here to the right side, passing it off there to Klein. Right going inside, out for a shot by Bridge.
Look at that rebound. And the foul. What a great job there, getting the board, going up strong by Angelini, and he'll have a chance to make it a three-point play. Bernard picks up his first. So with 4:48 to go, both teams have three fouls, and Angelini makes it a three-point play, and the game is a two-point game now with the Mustangs up by two.
Bernard's coming down the floor here off to DiLoretto. They're going to be passing the ball around a lot up top here. Barbeau's going to take the shot and doesn't make it.
Oh, but a nice save by Bernard. Redeeming Barbeau's ill-advised three, really. It was a very deep three.
Start over here and pass inside to Schultes.
No,
he can't finish it up either. We're going to have Bridge come down the floor here, passing it off to Wright. Moving the ball around very nicely by Waterloo. Bridge wanting to get inside
that
key.
That's an offensive foul. Nicely done by Ryan Higgins to draw that one. Got foul is on Wayne Bridge. That's his first foul. Fourth foul, one more, and Western will be shooting. Coming back in are Henderson and Chuck D taking off Higgins and Peter Schultes.
Bernard taking it down the floor here, off to Henderson, moving that ball around like they do. Bernard trying to get inside that key, passing it out there. DiLoretto for the three.
Money.
And gets it.
So the basket's good.
Nathan DiLoretto.
And there's a foul as well.
Going to be a foul on Jermaine Bernard.
But it was after the shot, so the basket counts. That's a
Western's
big three.
Fourth foul in this quarter.
Mm-hmm. Both teams in a little bit of trouble. Four fouls for each team.
We have Amen moving around here, trying to get past Bernard and handing it off there to Stevenson. He's working hard, trying to get inside that key, but Charlie took it off him instead, and we have Nick Berardi back on the court here, giving it off to Bernard. Down to Charlie, and Charlie's working inside, passing it out for Nick for the shot. Charlie drew in with that rebound. Barbeau at the side here, looking for Charlie, and Charlie back out to Berardi.
The spin, the kick.
Gives it to Charlie for the shot.
That's a foul on DiLoretto. Threw the guy to the ground. That's not exactly legal. I just can't help but notice. Check out the shoes on
Nick Berardi.
Those are some nice kicks.
Purple, some lime green, yeah, and pink in there.
Those are some 80s bowling shoes if I've ever seen them. Playing on a basketball court. Maybe get me a pair of those. Free advertising here for Nike. So we got
Zach Angelini at the line.
Ah, but he hits the front rim on the first. Angelini on the season is shooting 88% from the line.
The second one is good. And we have Barbeau with the ball here. Warriors back on defense. Charlie drew it up top. Moving the ball around quickly. Inside to Charlie. Charlie to DiLoretto. And the whistle is blown.
We got before the shot, it looks like.
DiLoretto at the line.
Before the shot, but it's five fouls. So it's every shot's basically a shooting foul anyway. See what DiLoretto can do from the line. Money
gets
on the first.
His first one.
Nathan DiLoretto up to 11 points on the day. Pretty good considering he averages six.
Second one is good too, and we have Wright with the ball. Western moving back on their defense. Right up against Bernard. Bridge with it now. He's gonna go inside the key himself. There's going to be foul called against Charlie Druin there.
Looks like he's laboring a bit with his right wrist.
Mustang foul, number 21, Nick Berardi.
But the foul's on Berardi.
Nick Berardi, actually, for the foul.
Bridge will shoot two because every foul now, like I said, is a shooting foul. So Bridge heads back to the line. Bridge having a pretty good night, 7 points. Averages 10.9 points per game, so he's on his way to hitting that total. Trying to make 2 of 2 from the line here.
Rain Bridge, his second shot, and he makes it. We got a substitution here. Andrew Melbourne's back in the game, and we have Wayne Bridge taking a break here for Waterloo. Barbeau's going to take it down the floor for the Stangs, passing her off to Berardi, DiLoretto to Bernard, back to Barbeau. Very quick passes. They love to do that up top. Inside to DiLoretto's. He wants to get up to the basket. Passes out to Berardi for the shot. Too long, though. It's Berardi's going to hold on to it again. Barbeau's at the top. Losing his drill, will pass it inside to Charlie.
Beauty pass to Chuck
Charlie
D.
Charlie finishes it off.
Nice job by Barbeau finding Chuck D. Now, what would you do if I told you before the game that after three quarters, Chuck D would have more points than Ryan Barbeau?
The shot is up by Angelini. And Western got that rebound, and Barbeau's taking it down the floor here. Moving out. Passing off to Charlie, down to the corner to Bernard. Bernard up for the shot and can't quite get it in there. And Wright got that rebound. Waterloo's taking it down the floor. Wright's up against Barbeau, but he takes a shot and doesn't quite get it, but rebounded by.
Beautiful moves of the ball. Wow, slick hands on the guy.
We have A-man up for the shot. Barbeau
Amen.
With that rebound, though, over all those players. And he's going to pass it off to Charlie. And it looks like there's going to be foul called against Waterloo.
Chuck D looks to be in some kind of pain every time he hits the ground. And he has been hitting the ground a lot. We've got Schultes and Higgins coming in for Berardi. And Ryan Barbeau coming off the floor. Having a rare breather. Mr. Druin with a chance to increase his point total.
Western's up by 6 points right now, hopefully to make it 8. On that roll there, 7.
Trying to pad their lead a bit.
Chuck D with one more. Doesn't get that one, though. That's all right, but we have Wright coming down the floor for Waterloo. Hands it off there to Melbourne. He comes around trying to get inside that key, but passes it off.
Look at that flying rebound by Mike Wright. No one even took note of him as he came in crashing the boards.
Bernard has it now, only 48 seconds left in the third quarter, passing off there to Schultes. Schultes looks like he's going to go inside the key himself, turn around, up for
a count
shot.
It.
Basket counts, and he's going to go to the line. Drew out that foul there.
Take control of the game. That's what Peter Schultes did there. Trying to keep the lead where it is. Don't want this game getting any closer than it is. It's been actually a very good job by the Mustangs. They haven't trailed at all in the second half. They've maintained about a three-point lead throughout the entire thing.
Hopefully they can keep this up in the next quarter, but it's a lot more playing time to happen.
Oh, plenty, especially with the way Waterloo's been hitting threes.
High rebound there by Zaki Angelini, but Wright has it now, and he's moving quickly. And Tolchev passes it off there to Melbourne as he's up top. Moving the ball around, calling for those screens, and he wants to get inside that key. Peter Schultes with that rebound, and Bernard's taking it down the floor here, trying to get to the bottom of the key there to Higgins as fast as he could, but wasn't there on time.
It'll be the last possession, I'd imagine, of the third quarter.
9 seconds left. We have Wright going through the key, passing out to one of his players, right for the last shot.
That would have been
doesn't
big.
Quite make it. It's a little short on that one. And that is the end of the third quarter. Your score, Mustangs at 56, Waterloo Warriors at 49.
Yeah, it's been Mike Wright leading the way to this point for the Waterloo Warriors. And for Western, it's Peter Schultes, of course. And the University of Western Ontario, as I've mentioned before, has 241 academic All-Canadian athletes, and our third hero of the classroom this evening is Caroline Earhart, who, as we mentioned before, is this week's Good Life Female Athlete of the Week. She's currently in her second year of her undergraduate degree in health promotion, and she likes to help younger kids through London's Western's Junior Development Program. She is hoping to break the Canadian triple jump record one day, and her biggest fear is getting seriously injured and having to take time off from the sport she loves. Caroline Earhart, hero of the classroom, and we'll be right back with fourth quarter action here on Mustangs TV.
It's game day. Today, tomorrow, every day. Game face is our only face. We're not normal. Normal doesn't run everywhere or take a stopwatch to everything. Normal doesn't dedicate itself to never letting its customers down. Not a single one. Never, ever, ever. Normal doesn't live to beat the rush. Obsessed about out-the-door times? That's not normal. Counting pepperoni in your sleep? Not normal. Normal is average. Normal is ordinary. Normal is what people expect. Normal doesn't have pizza sauce flowing through its veins. The other guy is normal. That's why no one delivers like we do.
What is the good life?
Far behind him at 49.
Yep. It's been Schultes leading the way with 16. DiLoreto chipping in with 12. And Chuck D, 7 points but 8 rebounds.
We have Wright up top here with the ball, trying to get inside there to Bridge. And he's called out of bounds on that one. We have Henderson throw it in here to Barbeau. The Warriors moving back on defense. Barbeau comes down the right side of the court. Passing off there to Henderson. A lot of movement up top. Barbeau comes back and throws it down to the corner there to Higgins. Peter Schultes for the three.
Foul, poor kick.
Gets it. What a game for Peter Schultes.
Yeah, 20 last game against Laurier. A lot of those were in garbage time, but these are not garbage points. These are big points for Western as the lead grows to 10.
We have Angelini trying to get inside that
key.
That's
an offensive foul. What a game by Schultes today. Taking charge, knowing his captain, Ryan Barbeau, not exactly having his best game. So Schultes.
That's all right. His team has picked it up tonight. Exactly what we need to see. We need to see Peter Schultes and Ryan Barbeau on the same track, on the same game. And that would be one to watch right there. Di Loretto for the three, and he gets it. And the bench is on their feet cheering for that one.
Di Loretto.
Nathan Di Loretto.
He has picked it up. 15 points for Di Loretto. How about that? As the ball's lost out of bounds. Yeah, Waterloo needs to call a timeout. 62 for Western. Waterloo 49. They are starting to pull away. Mustangs fans, after the game, make sure to check out westernmustangs.ca for up-to-date Mustang score schedule, stories, and highlights. westernmustangs.ca is your source for all Western Mustangs information. Our next game here is Saturday the 4th, like I said, against Brock. They do have two games in between, at Laurier on Saturday, and then next Wednesday they play at the University of Guelph. Both, of course, doubleheaders with the females. So tune in on the 4th, though, on Mustangs TV. We will have the doubleheader with the Brock Badgers.
Something to point out here, we just had our Lady Mustangs pull away a huge win against the Waterloo Warriors. The female Mustangs at 85 and Waterloo at just 42.
Yep, Mustangs playing some very good basketball recently, up to 7-8. They've won three of the last five games, and they are in position to make a playoff run here.
Hopefully they can keep that streak moving.
Yep, they've got a tough game at Laurier and a game they have to have at Guelph, as Guelph is right with them in the standings. A win, and that makes a huge difference for them going forward. And it looks like we're just about ready for action here. Barbeau inbounds the ball, and apparently they didn't do it right. Have to try that again. Such a simple thing as inbounding the ball. Try that again.
Higgins passing it off there to Barbeau. Moving that ball around. Higgins to the left side here. Inside to Schultes, passing it back out. Loses the ball there. And it is in Bridges' hands as he comes down the floor quickly and he finishes it off. Ryan Barbeau down the left side of the court for the Stangs, giving off to his players, passing it around here up top to Di Loretto for the three. Doesn't quite make that one.
Look at that from Schultes, though.
Barbeau with the second
shot. That's about time.
Yes, it is. And his teammates are happy about that one.
They're up on their feet on the bench every time a play happens. They're still on their feet.
They can't sit down. And Di Loretto going down the floor, passing it off there to Barbeau.
Nicely done.
And there we go. Ryan Barbeau is coming back.
And another timeout from Waterloo. The last one didn't really do a whole lot. 67-51 is the score, and the University of Western Ontario has 241 academic All-Canadian athletes. Our last one of the evening is Mustangs wrestler Stephen Takahashi. 2011 was a great year for Stephen. He was named CIS Rookie of the Year, OUA MVP and Rookie of the Year, and OUA and CIS All-Star. He's currently studying kinesiology and is in line to go to Ivy. He credits his good time management skills that help him balance his time between academics and wrestling. His favorite part of being on a varsity team is competition. Stephen Takahashi is a hero of the classroom, and we're going to take a quick break, but we'll be right back here on Monday.
Barbeau at the top here for the Stangs, passing it off to Henderson inside to Schultes. Back out to Barbeau for a long three.
Oh,
and he gets it right,
pumped.
Barbeau. Look at that fist bump right there. He's happy about that one.
Oh,
right with the ball inside the key, trying to get up there. Rebounded by Schultes. Yeah,
took a big load off his shoulders hitting that three. Is it two in a row? How about this going
up for himself?
Oh,
look at this. Bryant's coming back.
He's up to 14 points. That's the thing about him. He's such an explosive scorer. You blink and all of a sudden he's in double digits and counting.
Right up top with the ball. Trying to get inside that key, but out to Angelini. Back out there to the quarter. And that is a three.
Krejcich up to 8 points, trying to keep his team in it. But they find themselves down 16 points.
6 minutes and 30 seconds left. Ryan was going to take that shot, but was stopped there by Angelini, and the whistle was blown.
And it's good.
Looking around, they don't know what that was.
Krejcich. Nope, it's on Melbourne. If it was on Krejcich, he'd be done, but it's on Melbourne. So that's only two on Melbourne, two for Waterloo in the quarter.
Luke
Heyman comes back in. Barbeau up to 14 points already here in the fourth.
DiLoreto up top with the ball, gives it off to Schultes, down to the bottom to Barbeau.
Wow, he had 4 points in the first three quarters, and in the first 3.5 minutes, he already has 12 in the fourth quarter alone.
It's amazing, right up top here with the ball, passing it off to Angelini for the three, and doesn't quite get it. Rebounded there by Ryan Higgins as Barbeau's going to take it down the floor here for the Stangs. Waterloo moving back on defense. Barbeau's calling out the play here for his men. Moving the ball around inside to Schultes.
Oh,
would have been beautiful. There's going to be a foul called against Peter Schultes.
That's three for Schultes.
He wasn't happy about that one. He really wanted that ball back to finish off what he started. And Warriors coming down the floor, right with the ball in his hand. Going down the left side of the key, wanting to get in there, but passing it off to Amon.
Barbeau gets called on the foul. That's his second of the game. And look what happens when Barbeau starts scoring. The lead just balloons. It's up to 18.
Ball is in right for that shot. Higgins got that rebound. And Barbeau's going to take it down here for the Stangs. Coming down the left side. He's going to hand it off there. DiLoreto to Henderson. Henderson looking inside that key there for DiLoreto, but couldn't quite get there. We're going to have a substitution here. Max Klein is going to come in for Zach Angelini. Nathan DiLoreto up top with the ball down to Peter Schultes. Cross the court to Quinn Henderson for the three. What a roll Western has been having. A timeout is called from Waterloo's bench. And we are at 77 for our Mustangs and 56 for the Waterloo Warriors, and just 5 minutes and 27 seconds left in this game.
Pulling away. Mustangs fans, share your thoughts with us on Twitter. Tell us where you're watching from and what you think of the team's performance tonight. Follow at Mustangs TV and use hashtag Mustangs TV when tweeting about Mustangs athletics. Well, we'll be right back with the conclusion of this game here on Mustangs TV.
New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and 4 of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating.
Back here just at the end of the timeout in the fourth quarter, 5 minutes 27 seconds left on the game. 77 for our Stangs, 56 for Waterloo Warriors.
I don't know what happened in between the third quarters, but Ryan Barbeau all of a sudden has just gone off here in the fourth. Up to 16 on the game, 12 in the fourth. And Peter Schultes continues to lead the way with 19.
With Amon passing off to Queen there, trying to hand it off to Wright, and there's going to be foul called on Queen Henderson. Mustangs 13 foul.
That's going to be the fourth on Henderson. Are you going to take him out? Nope.
Not that big of a deal, just in the last few minutes of the game.
With a 21-point lead, yeah. Doesn't really matter that much. I'm actually surprised the starters are still on the floor.
We want to keep this lead. Mm-hmm. Melbourne with the ball, trying to get that shot up there. Schultes with that rebound. Barbeau is going to hold on to it as he is going to take it for the Stangs. Down the floor, off to DiLoreto. Schultes with it now, holding on to it. 10 seconds left on that shot clock. DiLoreto passing it inside to Schultes. 6 seconds left.
Got
to
shoot it.
Schultes is going to go up for the shot.
Oh no.
Barely.
Just came out there. But
Clean with that Clean shot misses, that didn't go in.
Yep, it's a good job by Schultes, hustling back, scared the Klein and forced him to take an awkward shot.
Barbeau on the left side here is going to take a three, bounces off the front of the rim there. We're going to have Melbourne up for a jump shot and finishes it off there. Ryan Barbeau coming down the floor, very calm now. Waterloo on their defense as Barbeau gives it off to DiLoreto, and he tries passing it inside the key there to Schultes, and a foul is going to be called against Max Klein from the Warriors.
That's his third foul. Got four, I believe, on the team. Just three, my bad. See the.
They have Mike Wright, who's coming off the floor.
Oh, look at that rebound by Higgins. He can get up there.
Henderson passing there to Barbeau. See, tell Schultes where he wants that screen. Ends up moving backwards and passing it out there to Quinn. And it comes off of Quinn Henderson. Is going to be a Warriors ball.
3:30 to go. Western with a handy 19-point lead.
Just a matter of Melbourne moving the ball around here, passing it back out to Pedges. And Klein went up for that shot, and he made it. And the whistle was blown on that play as well, so he's going to go to the line.
Klein gets it to camp, and he'll go to the line. First-year starter has made 8 of 13 free throws on the season. That is 62%. And DiLoreto goes off. And Jermaine Bernard back on the floor for the Mustangs.
And the shot is up, and he makes it through.
Makes it, and he'll take a seat. And coming in is Greg Filgiano, 6'8 freshman. Markham, Ontario, getting some action here.
Ryan Barbeau with the ball at the top here, off to Schultes, handing it back to Barbeau. A couple men on him as he goes.
Look at that.
Up for the shot, and Ryan Barbeau finishes it off.
So good at shaking off the defender. Does so right there again, finds himself an easy layup.
Amon with the ball going down the left side of the key, up for the shot. Rebounded by the Warrior player, and he's going to take his second shot in a row, and he gets that one in.
Amon got his first basket of the game.
Barbeau with it up top here for the Stangs. Warriors on defense. He's moving the ball around, taking his time. 8 seconds left on that shot clock, though.
Deflected. And we've got a timeout by the Western Mustangs. It is 79-63. Western leads. 2 minutes, 22 seconds to go. We'll be right back with Mustangs TV. Super Bowl the next day, why not check out some Mustangs basketball? You're going to be busy all day cooking your snacks and making your nacho dips, and I know I will be. And I know you should be too, and you should be tuning in. Watch the Brock Badgers take on your Western Mustangs here on Mustangs TV. We got just under 2.5 to go. 4 seconds on the clock. They got to be quick. It's going to have to be Higgins.
Bell passed off to Higgins. Higgins for the last quick shot there. Didn't make it through.
At least hit the rim.
We have A-man coming down the floor here for Waterloo, trying to go down that left side, but takes the shot instead, and he gets it in. Bernard has the ball for the Mustangs. Waterloo moving back on D. Bernard moving the ball around here, going to give it off there to Schultes. Back to Barbeau to make a move. 6 seconds on that shot clock. He's going to have to make it now. Henderson for the shot. Oh, doesn't make that three, but rebounded there by the Warriors, and we're going to have Melbourne with the ball. Passing.
Oh, that's a nice play.
Out there, great play. Finish it off by Phil Giano.
Mustangs lead is just 12, but
minute 20 left.
I don't think there's enough time for Waterloo to make a run here. They need a miracle and a half to pull this one out.
Western knows that they just need to waste their time as much as they can, hold on to the ball to the last few seconds, and then make their shots. And that's what they seem to be doing. It's going to be a black ball. It's going to be off of a Western.
It's only 64 seconds to play, though, and with a 12-point lead, they need threes galore, and Western to turn the ball over or miss free throws.
A-man with the ball up top, still trying to get down that left side of the key, and he did it this time.
A-man with 6 points in the last 2 minutes.
And we are down to the last few seconds of the game. 45 seconds here left in the quarter. Barbeau passing out to Bernard for the shot. Doesn't hit that rim, though.
Barbeau gets stuffed. Good play.
Kochev passing it off. Out there to A-man for the three. Can't quite get it in, though. And then Henderson's going to take that ball back. 20 seconds left in this game. Moving that ball around, wasting as much time as they can. Barbeau up top with it now. 10 seconds on that shot clock. Pretty much in line with the time of the game, and Barbeau's going to go for the last basket.
Of course
basket.
He makes it.
Ryan Barbeau finished that off.
Oh, that almost went in. Holy smokes.
And that is the end of the game. We have our Mustangs finishing off at 81 against the Waterloo Warriors at only 69.
Barbeau went into the fourth with 4 points, and he emerged with 20. So if you at home are worried about Barbeau losing points off his average, you're really not going to see it. But I think the player of the game, in my opinion, Peter Schultes, he had 19 points. He carried the team on his back early when Barbeau was ice cold. And he chipped in with plenty of rebounds, too. And the Mustangs improved their record to 5-10. Warriors have now lost 10 consecutive games.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us here this evening at Alumni Hall in men's basketball action.
Maybe you've never owned a Corolla,
but chances are you've ridden in one.
It's how you got to the church on time.
Maybe you came home in one.
Slept in the back.
or spend some quality time there.
Chances are, you helped somebody move in one.
Or stuffed the trunk and slammed the door and just went somewhere.
Maybe you found a friend in one.
Or found yourself.
You don't have to have owned a Corolla to know a Corolla.
But maybe now, your time has come.
The new 2011 Corolla. New style, new standard safety features, and as fuel efficient as ever. It's the car you can count on.
Getting a lot of playing time. How are you handling all the minutes you're getting?
I'm used to it. I've been doing it for 3 years now. I just try and do what I can do, and just try and play through all the minutes I'm playing. It's tough, but I'm doing it. I think I'm doing a good job.
And you guys face Laurier this Saturday. What do you think the team really needs to focus on for that game?
The last game we played them, we got it rebounded. So I think that game we got to be a little tougher. We just got to execute a little better. I think we'll be fine to win that game too.
All right. Well, thanks so much, and good luck on Saturday.
Thank you.
Thanks. Back to you guys.
On behalf of the University of Western Ontario, Mustangs Athletics, and Mustangs TV crew, thank you for watching tonight's broadcast of Mustangs TV on SSN Canada.
Usually they'll talk for more, but are you guys taking off now?
Played them with